Hi, my name is William Bellamy. I'm a principal escalation engineer supporting Microsoft Windows Azure. Today, I'll be demonstrating how to enable the remote desktop feature on a Windows Azure cloud service. Dynamically enabled remote desktop is an important new feature that enables secure troubleshooting. Many times, remote desktop is not enabled during deployment because of security concerns. In this demonstration, I will show how to enable remote desktop at runtime in the Windows Azure Management Portal, and then disable it. The first thing you need to do is log on to the Windows Azure Management Portal. You do this at https://manage.windowsazure.com. From there, you can choose the cloud service on which you want to enable remote desktop. In our case, we have a cloud service named cohowinery.cloudapp.net. Clicking on the certificates menu, you can see that there are no certificates configured for this cloud service. So without a PFX service certificate, there's no way to encrypt the remote desktop password. So that's one of our requirements. So let's go back to the configure menu. At the bottom, there's a remote button. Let's click there, and that will give us access to the configure remote desktop dialog. The first option is roles. So you determine whether you want remote desktop enabled on all of your roles or only some of your roles. In our case, we're going to leave the default and enable remote desktop on all the roles. The most important thing on this dialog is this checkbox right here. When you check it, you are enabling remote desktop as soon as you click on the complete button at the bottom. So that gives you access to three vital pieces of information: the username, the password, and the expires on date. So the username and password are very important, and your choices should be made wisely because that's what's going to protect you from hackers on the internet. So once I've entered in my username and password, then we have to look at the certificate. As we saw, we don't have a certificate, so this will enable the automatic creation of a certificate. Finally, we have to give an expires on date. So we're going to choose July 4th. Now, when we click on this complete button, the first thing that will happen is the certificate will be created. Once the certificate is created, that plus this configuration information will then be pushed out to each instance, and then the roles will be configured, restarted, and at that point, traffic will be enabled. So as you can see at the bottom of the screen, you have a status message, configuring remote desktop for cloud services Coho Winery. When you click on the details button, you see the status, adding extensions to the cloud service. Now when you click back at certificates, the certificate has shown up, and now we can click over to the instances menu, and the status message says configuring remote desktop for cloud services Coho Winery. So now the configuration process will happen. As you can see, we have two instances for each of our two roles. Now what that enables is that we can use the update domains so that we have continuity of service. While the two instances IN_0 are being updated, the two other instances IN_1 are going to stay running. Once the first set of two instances are updated, then the second two will be updated. So now you can see the first two sets have been updated. So now when you click on that instance, you can see at the bottom there's a connect button. So let's click on the connect button. So we'll click on the open and you get this first warning. So let's click on connect and we'll enter in our password and click on OK. And you get this warning, which if you click on this checkbox, you won't get it a second time. And as you can see, we have now connected to one of our instances. Now, let's say you've run your troubleshooting and you'd like to lock your instances back down. So you'd like to disable remote desktop. The process is the same. You click on configure menu, then the remote button at the bottom. You uncheck this enable remote desktop. And you click on the complete button. And the process is identical. It goes through, it updates your instances, and then once that's done, you'll no longer be able to connect with remote desktop. This concludes the demonstration of enabling and disabling remote desktop in the Windows Azure Management Portal. In this video, I've demonstrated how to dynamically enable and disable the remote desktop feature from the Windows Azure Management Portal. Thank you for watching. And I look forward to seeing your great cloud services on Windows Azure.